This is the video essay, work group video essay, and I'm supposed to introduce the series The Handmaid's Tale. The Handmaid's Tale is produced by Bruce Miller and first premiered in the 26th of April 2017. The show follows our main protagonist, our main protagonist, Offred, and is set in a near dystopian future. Our main character, Offred, or as she, her real name is June, live in this dystopian future. Some other secondary character which plays a big role in the series and the first episode are Nick, Commander Waterford's driver, and Commander Waterford. We get a brief introduction of Commander Waterford in the first episode. Commander Waterford seems to be a powerful man in this new state, and seems to be placed high in the hierarchy. We see this when Offred is at shopping for him, and she's told to tell the shop owners that it's for him, so they won't mess around. We also meet his wife, Waterford's wife, Serena, who is ha having, it seems like, having some problems adapting to this new society and the rules that she has to follow. This is clear when Offred is forced to have sex with Waterford, and she seems kind of hard adapting to this. Another character we meet in this series, The Handmaid's Tale, is Aunt Lydia. We don't know much about her, but it seems like she's in charge of these handmaids. As said before, this is science fiction, a dystopian fiction, and some of the main themes we see in the story are religion and evil, because this new state is a theocracy.
In the first scene we've chosen, it's the scene where Aunt Lydia teaches the handmaids how to be handmaids. In this scene, religion and God is in focus, and it's the first episode of the series when we see religion plays a big role in this new dystopian feature. In the scene, there's also a flashback which shows how the world was before. It was a more liberal world. Like the world we know today. It's clear to see that we can consider the government as a theocracy. This is seen in the scene with Aunt Lydia and how she uses her authority over the handmaids. She used the biblical phrase, so God whipped up a special plague, the plague of infertility. She kind of excuses her actions with religious excuses. Also, the light that sheds into the room looks like light from above or from heaven, which give Aunt Lydia some kind of god status in some way. Furthermore, we see Aunt Lydia's authority through the dressing in the scene. She has a different dress than the others. Yeah, this give her the authority. And finally, the close-up that there is on Offred's face shows the kind of despair and desperation she experiencing with this new world order. The second scene we've chosen is the scene where the commander Fred have or carries out intercourse with Offred. This is also a scene where some of the evil aspects are shown, since he's raping Offred in this situation. Like Aunt Lydia, and like throughout lots of the series, he uses biblical stories and references to justify it. This shows that the society is ruled with religious laws. It's a totalitarian theocracy. In the scene, there are also some very important face expressions, just like in the first scene we chose. The commander chases his face from superior to kind of inferior when he climaxes. Meanwhile, Serena, his wife, and Alfred faces they remain totally unchanged. This kind of shows the how sad the situation kind of is, and Alfred is just going with it. You don't have a choice. She is depressed, or she lives under oppression. It's becomes quite clear. In the beginning of the scene, the commander is portrayed like a pastor or a priest of sort. He kind of stands in front of the whole room, and he says, "We shall begin." And he, of course, as we said, he uses the Bible. The dark light in the scene also says a lot about the mood in the house or in the world and so on. It kind of emphasizes that none of the involved parts are really enjoying the situation. The theme evil plays a big part in the series. We can see how some women are used and sexually harassed, and how punishment is let out on the people not following the orders from above. All these factors plays into the dystopian fiction. Then there's religion / theocracy. Religion is seen through the whole episode, but is essential in the two scenes we chose. Religion is used as an excuse for action we see in the clips. This could be that we see intercourse is filled with Bible verses. We can consider the new government as a theocracy. This is seen in the series with Aunt Lydia and how she has the authority over the handmaids. This plays a big part in the society.
Context. As said earlier, one of the main themes in the series The Handmaid's Tale is dystopian and evil. We can draw parallels to other texts and movies we have read and seen. For example, we can draw parallel to the text The Man Who Loved Flowers and the movie The Beach. In the story, The Man Who Loved Flowers has a lot in common with The Handmaid's Tale. In The Man Who Loved Flowers, there's a lot of evil. We see a lot of evil. An example of this is when the main character in the story brutally murders a woman for no apparent reason. We also see this evil in The Handmaid's Tale. An example of this is when Alfred and Emily is walking home. We see how Alfred sees three people hanging from a bridge. As said, there's also some parallels with the movie The Beach. In the movie The Beach, the main theme, or one of the main themes, is dystopian, and this is also one of the main themes in The Handmaid's Tale. In both stories, we see how our main protagonist kind of is robbed of his freedom and has to obey the laws of their rulers.